Hello children, I am Varalakshmi and today we are going to learn about average. Let us understand the concept of average using a small activity. Okay? I have poured juice in these glasses. Did you all notice children? Yes. My friends are coming today and I want to give them this juice. But I am worried that all the glasses are not having same amount of juice. Yes or no children? This glass is having only 1 unit of juice. This is having 5 units. This is having 3, 4 and 2 units of juice. So I am not satisfied because some friends will get more juice, some friends will get less juice. So let me try. What can I do with this? I'll try to pour some juice from this to this. Is that okay? No. Let me try. So, children, what am I trying to do here? I'm trying to find the average value of this given values. Now, all the glasses are having same amount of juice. 3 units, 3 units, 3, 3, 3. Yes? So, I'm trying to find average value. That is the middle value of the given set of values. Average value always lies in between the smallest and the biggest quantities. Okay? Shall we see the formula for this average? And we will also find average of the same set of given values using the formula. Okay? Yes. Now, I have written the formula of average here. Average is equal to sum of quantities divided by number of quantities. Sum of quantities means you all know the meaning of the word sum. Sum means answer of addition. Yes or no? Yes. So, initially the glasses were having 1 unit, 3, 4, 5, 2, like this, right? So, the glasses were having 1 unit, 3, 4, 5 and 2 units of juice. So, we have to add all these because it is the formula is saying sum of quantities. Sum means we have to add. Now, divided by number of quantities. Number means how many quantities are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 quantities. So, sum is, add all these, 1 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 2 is 15 divided by 5. So, 5 ones are, 5 threes are. Average is 3. So, that's what we got here. Yes or no children, all the glasses are having 3 units of juice. So this is nothing but finding the average using the formula. Shall we see one more example of finding average using the formula? Yes. Now I'll take few values like 10, 20, 30. I want to find the average value of these given set of values. I will use the formula sum of quantities. That means I have to add all these. 10 plus 20 plus 30 divided by number of quantities. 1, 2, 3. Sum is 10 plus 20 plus 30. 60 divided by 3. So, if I cancel, I will get 20. So, 20 is the average of the given set of values. Now, if you observe this 20, it is in between the smallest and the greatest values. Okay? So average always lies in between the smallest and greatest values. I hope you understood this. Thank you, children.